Hello there, my inspirations. My name is Inspir Asper. You just got your hands on your first launch pad, and that's very exciting. But now you may be wondering, how do you make your first cover with it? Well, hopefully that's what I'll be teaching you in this video. Now, before we begin, I'm going to approach this tutorial as if you have had no prior experience with the launch pad or with Ableton. That being said, let's get into it and learn how to make our first launch pad cover. To start, obviously, get a hold of your launch pad and plug it into your computer. Now, open Ableton Live. A copy of Ableton Lite should have come with your launch pad. Open up Ableton and you should see a screen that looks like this. To start, I'm going to press the Tab button on my computer to go into Ableton's arrangement view. Or alternatively, up here on the top right, you can click this button or this button to alternate between the views. Primarily, I'll be working in Ableton's arrangement view. First things you'll notice is that you have two MIDI tracks and two audio tracks to work with. For now, I'm just gonna delete the audio tracks by clicking them and pressing the delete button on my computer. This is purely for the sake of organization for now, for displaying exactly how we're gonna approach this tutorial. You will be needing audio tracks later. To add any audio or MIDI tracks, right-click in this empty space and insert either audio or MIDI. But for now, let's work with these two MIDI tracks. I'm gonna rename the top one Samples by right-clicking and selecting Rename, and then I'm gonna rename the second MIDI track, Lights. The track I named Samples is where I'll be adding in all of our samples, our audio files that will be triggering at the touch of a button. And then the Lights MIDI track, as you may have guessed, will trigger certain light effects based on what button we press. First, we need to arm our Samples MIDI track for recording. We do that by pressing this button right here. It should turn red. That tells Ableton that whatever MIDI input we're receiving will trigger all the samples that we will then set up later. Next, let's set up our Lights MIDI track to display output. We do this by pressing this button right here that says In, and then we click this drop-down button that says No Output, and we select our launch pad. So in my case, I'm gonna select Launchpad Pro Output, Launchpad Pro Live Port. It's a bit of a mouthful, but at this point, you'll be selecting your launch pad. So if you have a Launchpad S, select your Launchpad S for output. Now, this next step only applies for those of you who have the Launchpad Pro and the Launchpad Mark II. Click this drop-down bar that says Channel 1 and select Channel 6. Now, if you have the Launchpad S and Mini, leave it at 1. Mark II and Pro, leave it at 6. If you set up your Lights MIDI track correctly, you should see some light feedback on your Launchpad. Next, let's add in some drum racks into our Samples MIDI track, so that way we can later press a button and then actually trigger a sound. We can do this by going to the left side of Ableton, under the library, under Instruments. Click an instrument rack and drag it onto our Samples MIDI track. You should see this appear at the bottom. Let's click this black button to expand our instrument rack. Then, under Instruments again, let's click a drum rack and drag it here, inside of that instrument rack. This is where we'll be adding our audio files that we want to trigger at the touch of a button. Let's say, for example, I want to press this button and make a sound. You'll notice inside this drum rack, there'll be a yellow button that lights up. I can click over here on the left to navigate between my different pages of 16 buttons, and you'll see right here, this particular button is mapped to this square. That's where I can add an audio file, so I can press a button here to make a sound. Next, let's do a very similar setup, but for our lights. This time, let's go under MIDI effects, click and drag a MIDI effect rack onto our lights MIDI track. You should see this. This looks very similar to our instrument rack that we just did. Let's expand it again by clicking that button, and let's drag another MIDI effect rack right here inside our previous MIDI effect rack, and we can expand that as well. Essentially, what this allows us to do is then add in light effects, but for our particular button. Very similar to how the samples can be triggered by one button, we can make a particular light effect for that button. For example, if I were to right-click here and select Create Chain, I can then isolate a particular button. Let's say this one. You'll notice that this red bar lights up down here. I can then select this, or alternatively, while holding this button, double-click, and now this button is the only button that should be receiving the light. You'll notice I'm pressing these buttons, but only this one receives light, because that's the only one I've mapped to create a light effect. Whereas if I expand it to cover all of the lights, every light will have input now. This is then where we can build our light effects using these MIDI effects. Or if you have Max for Live, you can actually then add in an external MIDI device that allows you to create MIDI clips as light effects. So what we've just done is allowed us to play 64 buttons of samples and trigger light effects, which is neat, but you can actually have more than just these 64 buttons. You can actually have these 64 times 8 unique buttons. So let's say, for example, I want to press this button, and then later in my cover, I want to press this button and then play something completely different. To do this, let's go into our samples MIDI track, select our drum rack, copy it, and paste it. Then click this chain button, move this blue square over just by one. You can do that by hovering over it till your cursor looks like this, click and drag to the left. You'll see this is under chain 0, and this one is under chain 1. Let's copy these both and paste them again, select them, and then drag them over again. I'm clicking here, holding shift, clicking this bottom one, copy, paste, select them all, and move their chains over. So we just made 8 different pages of samples. Let's actually rename them. I'm gonna name this page 1, and I'm just gonna rename each page. Great, so now I know which page is what. But how do we access these pages? What we can do is right-click over this orange bar and select Map to Macro 1. Then what we can do is go to the top right of Ableton, click this button that says MIDI, select this chain selector, that's what we just made, press this top right circle button on your launchpad, and while holding it, press the bottom right. Then this should appear at the top left of Ableton because of that. Click this orange box where it says 127 and type in 7, select enter. So that was a lot. What did we just do? Essentially what we just did was we mapped the pages from 0 to 7, which is 8 unique buttons. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Those are 8 different pages. If you did that right, then what you should see is every time I press one of these buttons, look here at this orange bar, it'll then move to that number. So if I press this button, for example, number 3, remember, 0, 1, 2, 3, we then move to chain number 3, which selects page 4. I guess I could have renamed it this page 0, page 1, because my page numbers start at 1, whereas the chains start at 0, whatever. The point is, this allows you to create 8 separate pages of buttons. Let's do the same exact thing for our lights. Remember, we can click on our lights MIDI track, go under chain, right click, map to macro 1, MIDI, click chain selector, top right button, bottom right button, 127, change that to 7, enter. Now we haven't actually made 8 separate pages of our lights, so let's do that real quick. Same way we did before. Okay, and one real easy way to verify that we did this correctly was under our lights, let's go under some random page, say page 6 for example. Let's go into this MIDI effect rack, add a velocity into it, and change this number to a different color. Learning the different colors for the launch pads will take some time, but for my example, Launchpad Pro, this number 5 should turn to a red. So that means on our 6th page, so this one right here, if I press this button, and then press a button, I should see red. And then if I switch back to any other page, it should turn to that default orange color. So that's a good way of knowing that we actually set up these pages correctly. I'm just gonna undo that for now. So our setup's done. Great, that's actually really awesome. The next step is to actually build your cover. I'm going to add in an audio track. Remember, I did that by right-clicking in this space on Ableton and then selecting Insert Audio Track. I'm gonna rename this, though I don't have to. I'm just gonna say song. Also, be sure to save your project every now and then, just a friendly reminder. You don't want to put a lot of effort into it just to lose some progress. Next, we have to add in our song to sample it, which we can then put onto the buttons. One thing I highly, highly, highly recommend doing, and so does the rest of the Launchpad community, is searching to see if your song has stems publicly available. Stems are the individual layers of a song. So let's say the particular leads alone, or maybe just the kicks of a song. If you are able to access stems for your song, you can then sample just the bass line and press it on this button, or something like that. Whereas it can be very, very hard to isolate a particular layer of a song from the final mix. You can find stems by just doing a quick search for insert your song name stems. Now, the realistic truth is you probably won't be able to find your stems for that song. More often than not, artists don't like giving out stems to their songs. However, there are a good amount out there that do have stems available, so just do a quick search. If you can't find stems for a song that you want, then dare I say, it's okay to use the final mix for your first Launchpad cover. I would argue your first Launchpad cover is getting down the basics of sampling, so just keep that in mind, that this is meant to be for practice. Once you have your audio files, we can drag them into Ableton onto an audio track. If you drag stems into Ableton in bulk, they will typically line up on the same audio track. So you will then have to add in multiple audio tracks and then line them up manually. Now keep in mind, if you have Ableton Lite, you can only have a max of 8 tracks at once. So you may not be able to line them up vertically to hear the entire song. To get around this, simply just use one audio track like this and sample them from here. Next, if it isn't set up already, make sure Ableton's BPM is that of your song. You can change Ableton's BPM by clicking up here, this number right now, where mine says 140, I believe the default is 120, you can click it and type in any number you want. I highly recommend you make Ableton's BPM match that of whatever song you're using. This will greatly help you when it comes to sampling. Also, in addition, make sure that all of your audio files are also the same BPM. You can check by double-clicking them and going down here and see the segment BPM. If Ableton's BPM matches your song, then you can simply click on warp. Make sure that this is grayed out. That will make sure that your audio files plays at the right speed and it won't become distorted or warped. Otherwise, you can click warp and then manually type in this segment BPM. Once you have your audio files and all the BPM is synced correctly, you can now start the process of sampling. Sampling, if done correctly, can be a little tedious, admittedly. However, good sampling makes for a good launchpad cover. In order to sample, I'm gonna zoom in on one of my audio tracks by clicking up here in Ableton and then scrolling down while holding left click. The farther you zoom in, typically you can make more precise cuts. To then add a cut in one of your audio files, make sure that this drop-down bar says none, otherwise you won't be able to do this. Right-click where you want and select split. Adding a split is essentially like taking a pair of scissors to your audio file and just cutting it right there and then. You can then add in a mirrored cut at the end of your audio file to signify that's what you want your audio file to be. So let's say, for example, I want to add a cut right here. I'm just gonna solo this track. Essentially what this audio file will then be, I'm gonna delete these just for the sake of showing you, this is what my audio file will be. And that's it. What you can then do is go to your samples track, go to whatever page you want, let's say for the sake of this tutorial, page 4 right here. Go onto page 4, select a button, let's say I want that particular sound to be right here. Find that in your drum rack. You can maneuver to a different set of 16 button grids by clicking over here. You can see that it's in this particular grid, and it's this particular button. Let's find our sample, click, and drag it onto here. Now, when I press this button, make sure I'm not soloing a track again. Let's press this button. I just played my first sample. That's exciting. One very, very useful tip for improving your launchpad covers is down here where it says fade in for your sample. I would recommend just giving it a slight fade in. Something within the range of, I don't know, 4 to 7 milliseconds. I'm just kind of making up that range, but just some small number. What this allows you to do is it gives a small attack on your sample. Over this 6.86 millisecond, which is a very short amount of time, the volume will go from completely silent to the volume of your clip. Whereas if you have it at zero, it's just instantaneous, and you may get some undesired snapping sounds. And in addition, I would recommend turning off this button that says snap. This prevents your audio file from stopping at on a grid line, which again, in the long run, will just create unnecessary clipping sounds. They're very subtle, but I highly recommend you avoid this. At this point, all you do is just sample your track. So you then add in splits wherever you want, create an audio file, go to your samples, pick some sort of button that you want, maybe page 2, for example, down here, and then add in your audio file. That's all you're gonna do at this point, is just sample. Next comes making your lights. Though, admittedly not necessary, light effects can be pretty neat for your first launchpad cover. Or for any launchpad cover, I suppose. This video is already running a little bit long in terms of time, so for the sake of this video, I'm not gonna cover lights now. However, I have made some previous tutorials explaining how to make light effects, so if you don't mind, I'm gonna plug those, and if you're curious, you can head on over and check them out. If you have Ableton Light, you're gonna make some light effects using these MIDI effects. You can check out this video by clicking this pop-up in the top right corner to learn how to make light effects using these MIDI effects. Or if you have Max for Live, like I mentioned, you can then trigger light effects using MIDI clips, which is a bit more advanced and allows you to do more. I have made multiple videos explaining how to do this, so you can also go and check those out. I'll put in some links in the description below so you can head over. Once you've sampled all your audio effects, added them onto your launch pad, and also let's pretend that I've made some cool light effects at the trigger of each, at the press of each button, then comes time to actually play your cover. Obviously, this is the point where I would recommend you take a lot of time to practice your cover. Once you feel satisfied and you're able to properly play your cover without any problems, any hiccups, you can then record your cover. You can do this by making sure that your sample's MIDI track, of course, is armed for recording. If it isn't, you won't be able to hear any sounds. But then what that allows you to do is record your sample's track. You can then click this button up here at Ableton. This is the record button. Click it, and you can begin recording. At this point, whatever I press will then be mirrored and recorded in Ableton. Now, at the moment, I don't have any buttons sampled to these. Let's say I press this button. It actually makes sound, right? Then what you can do is go back, play back what you just did, and it should sound pretty good. Then, at this point, what you can do is go to File, Export, and then export your samples track. This will export the cover that you just made as a raw audio file. Then what you can do is take the recording of you playing your cover and overlay that audio. So you essentially get nice high audio quality of the cover that you just played. Then edit your video, upload it, do whatever you want with it. I mean, of course, you don't necessarily have to record yourself playing this. You can just show your friends and family, whatever, what have you. But those are the very basics of making your first Launchpad cover, arguably a very significant cover in your Launchpad career. Hopefully at this point, this can then take you other places where you can learn advanced tricks and perfect your skills at the Launchpad. I hope I was able to acquaint you a little bit more with the Launchpad, get you familiar with how it all works. I wish you all the best with your futures and what you do with your Launchpad. Thank you for watching. I appreciate your support. Take care.